What's up, guys? How are you? Mr. Argueta coming to you week number 5. Congratulations on making it this far. What can I say? I'm happy that you guys are enjoying the videos. I get a lot of feedback from that and letting me know that it is a little more personalized and you feel like you're an actual part of a class instead of just getting a bunch of information thrown at you and going on from there. But I also wanted to just kind of start it off this week and giving you guys a quick shout out because we have reached a halfway mark and some of you guys are doing awesome. I mean, awesome. Super excited to see the results. I have graded everything up to this week. So all of the midterm is graded. So if you look at your grade right now, that is going to reflect where you're at this point. So not including week 5, of course, up to the midpoint. Lindsay, well done. Well done, Lindsay, Steven, Maya, or it could be Mia. Mia, is it Maya or is it Mia? Anyhow, Anthony, Sean, Kobe, Tommy, Destiny, Gracie, you're back up there under again. Gracie, well done. Carl and Caro, Shazwana. I wish you told me how to pronounce your name. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. Ashley, Desmond, Tanya, Antonio, Emily. This is a interesting name. Let's take a look here. What is this? Where am I? Antonio, Emily, and Amelia. That sounds right. Are Amelia? Maybe I'm wrong. Anyhow, all of you guys are killing it. Bobby, Simone, Megan, Miranda, just murdering this thing. Well done, guys. Super excited. We have a very good class this semester. Just excited to get to know you guys, some of your stories, some of your struggles. I can't wait till next week. We're going to be participating in my favorite discussion. This week, though, we talk about leaders and we talk about managers and the difference between them. In our discussion this week, we want to focus on what's really the difference when it comes down to a manager and a leader. So one of the questions I see asked a lot in management positions is, what's the difference between a manager and a leader? And can a good manager be a good leader and vice versa? So I want you guys to take a moment to sort of think about that and reflect upon people in your lives that have been good leaders and people who have been good managers. I want you to use your words. Please do not give me the book definition of this. So I want you to understand what I'm looking for you is for you to apply it and define it in your own words. Define it as if I was a 2-year-old or 4-year-old, 5-year-old kid and I couldn't understand it. Don't give me a definition from the book. Give me your definition. What you see as a good leader, as a good manager. I'm super excited to continue to read your post. I'm looking forward to next week. If you get a chance, please don't do this without doing your current week folder work. But if you get a chance, you can go into the discussion tab on the left-hand side. Look for where it says my favorite discussion, and there's a video. The video is a little lengthier than our normal videos. This is Dr. Randy Pottage. He was a professor in Carnegie Mellon, and they had a series, and it was called The Last Lecture. And The Last Lecture series was intended for if you were a professor and you had an opportunity to speak to your students for the last time, what would be your last lecture? When I saw this, I read the book and it really spoke to me. I was a actual business person at the time. And I want to say that at some point, this created a desire to become a professor. This gave me a vision to be a part of people's lives and to make a difference and to be deeper involved and in the process of succeeding. As you guys know, I am a first generation American and the first to go to college, the first to graduate, the first to start a business, the first to do a bunch of stuff. And I enjoy seeing the process of that. And I enjoy being a part of that journey with people. So this spoke to me, and I felt like it was important for me to incorporate this in my class. I think it fits in well with our that week's curriculum, which talks about goal setting and it talks about purpose statements. And what I want you to do is not only watch the video, and I hope that encourages you to follow your dreams, but more importantly, I hope that it helps you create a purpose statement, a personal purpose statement. What is your long and short-term goals, guys? What is it that you're trying to accomplish with this? What is the reason that you're here? Because that's what's going to hold you in continuing to fight through this process and this journey. I hope that this is a reflective moment, like some of the other things were. I know we've had some moments in our class where we reflect upon our ideas and concepts and theories and why we make decisions and what is a good leader, what is a good manager, like this week's conversation. But I hope this discussion gives you an opportunity to really search deep down inside and ask yourself, what is my goal? What is it that I'm trying to accomplish? One of my favorite and ultimate projects I had when I was going through my undergraduate was I had to write a speech, and how weird this was, but how powerful it was for me. And I was going through a class with public speaking, so speech writing, and the speech that we had to write was our own obituaries. Sounds crazy, right? But it made me sit down and say, what do I want people to say about me when I'm gone? And it made me write a speech about myself, forward looking, right? Looking at the end of this journey, and when everything is said and done and the curtains close, what do I want this world to remember me by? And that helped me. That helped me because at that time I was in my undergraduate, not knowing all the challenges that were gonna be in front of me. I didn't know the struggles I was gonna go through. I didn't know the hardship that I was gonna face and during that time. But I knew at that moment that my vision was to complete this degree, to be able to say, I was the first to do this. I did finish college. I was able to accomplish these things. So I hope that this next week creates that environment for you. What is it that you want to accomplish? So I'm excited about these next couple of weeks. We're almost done, guys. It's pretty quick. The semester goes by so fast. One of my regrets in this program is the fact that I get to read your posts, I get to learn about you, I get to read your stories and see sometimes your pictures and hear what's going on in your life. And I start getting attached. I'm not gonna lie, I start getting attached to some of your thoughts and your writing and seeing what you have to say and hearing what you have to say. And then all of a sudden, 7.5 weeks later, you're gone and never to be heard of again. Once in a while, some student will come back or stop by and visit, say, I was in your principal's management's class. And I love it because I get to connect at a level with you guys. But I do encourage you, if you haven't yet, let's connect on LinkedIn. I am on Facebook. It's not a super private, it's a very public site. I don't put any political post out there. I don't put anything that might offend anybody. It's just to stay in contact with people. And a lot of my previous students have connected that way. But LinkedIn is a good professional site. If you want to use me as a reference, please do so. But other than that, guys, I'm telling you, it's been a joy so far. I'm looking forward to it. This week, we have just a few things that you have to keep in mind. Of course, make sure you're taking advantage of every opportunity you can to get as many points as you possibly can. And this week, basically, you have your discussion, which you have to put your original post, reply to this video, and reply to two other students. Please make sure you get all of your points there. All right, so next week is week number 6, which includes my favorite discussion. And then week number 7 is the final week. So really, if we really step back and look at it, we have one more week before the final week. So just to make sure, I want you to understand, this is week 5. Week 6 is next week. Week 7 technically will not be right after week 6 because that's Thanksgiving week and the school shuts down and there's no homework assignments. So you don't have to do anything for that week. But then the week when we come back, which is the week of the 28th or 29th, that's your final week. That's week 7. So you're going to have 1 week break in between 6 and 7. All right. What else can I tell you? The weather these last couple days, phenomenal. I hope you're taking advantage of it, guys. So as you can tell, I'm getting older. So my body's getting a little stiff and hard. So what I did this week was I went to yoga. It was the first time I've ever had a yoga class. I thank God there was nothing being recorded because you guys would have had a laugh. I can't keep my balance. You know, I'm just, you know, I've added a couple more pounds than I wish I had. But I'm determined to start moving a little more, start getting a little more flexible and getting a little more mobile. So keep me in your thoughts there. And if you're a person of prayer, pray for your professor. I mean, I need to get a little more, stretch out. And I was doing all these yoga poses and, but anyhow, it was definitely a comical situation. But I encourage you, get on out there, stay healthy, be careful. This is awesome news that I've heard that the COVID numbers are starting to decline. We are seeing progress. Let's keep it going. I can't wait till this is over and done with. And I don't care what happens to that stupid thing. Let's just get rid of it. So guys, for all of you who are out there who are still struggling with it, keep the faith, stay strong. We're with you. And if you need me, guys, if you need me, please feel free to just email me or give me a call. I'm here for you. And last bit of information that I want you to know, if you are out there and you are struggling in some form, guys, we have resources for you. Please don't stay quiet. These are serious issues that we are living through. We have a lot of people have lost loved ones, have a lot of strain, stress, and pain. There are resources for you. We have in our Blackboard, there is a tab called Aspire Student Assistance that helps you with some counseling and therapy. Please take advantage of that. I don't want to hear that you guys feel like you had nowhere to turn when you have tons of resources available to help you. So I'm here for you. Have a great day, guys. It's always wonderful to hear what's going on in your life. Let me know. Hit me up with a reply. Let me know what's going on. Let's connect. Have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful week. Take care.